Stephen Sondheim is often regarded as the father of the modern musical. His shows were known for breaking the mold created by conventional Golden Age writers such as Cole Porter, George Gershwin, and Rodgers and Hammerstein. In fact, Oscar Hammerstein II was a close friend and mentor to Sondheim. Throughout his career, Sondheim experimented with source material, themes, and structure, and redefined what a musical could be. Many of his most revolutionary works feature prominent male characters, and for my project, I have chosen to study these characters and perform some of their most well-known songs.
Sunday in the Park with George tells a story based upon the famous painting, A Sunday Afternoon on the Island of La Grande Jatte, and the mysterious life of its creator, Georges Seurat. The production chronicles George and his great-grandson, also named George, and focuses on themes of art, emotional connection, and community. It opened May 2, 1984, at the Booth Theater and ran for 604 performances. The production was nominated for 10 Tony Awards and won 2. The song Finishing the Hat focuses on the internal struggle of an artist between his passion and devotion to his art and his commitments to the outside world.
Mademoiselles, you and me, pal. Second bottle, ah, she looks for me. Bonnet flapping, yapping, rough, chicken, pastry. Yes, she looks for me. Good. Let her look for me to tell me why she left me, as I always knew she would. I had thought she understood. They have never understood, and no reason that they should. But if anybody could. Finishing the hat. How you have to finish the hat. How you watch the rest of the world from a window while you finish the hat. Mapping out a sky. What you feel like to planning a sky. What you feel when voices that come through the window go until they distance and die. Until there's nothing but sky. And how you're always coming back too late from the grass or the stick. Or the dog or the light, and how the kind of woman willing to wait's not the kind that you want to find waiting to return you to the night. Dizzy from the height, coming from the hat, studying the hat, entering the world of the hat. Reaching through the world of the hat like a window, back to this one from that. Making out a face, stepping back to look at a face, leaves a little space in the way, like a window, but to see. It's the only way to see. But when the woman that you wanted goes, you can say to yourself, well, I did what I did. When the woman that you wanted knows that however you lived, there's a part of you always standing by, mapping out a sky. Finishing a hat, starting on a hat. Finishing a hat. Look, I made a hat. Where there never was a hat.
Sweeney Todd, The Demon Barber of Fleet Street, opened on March 1st, 1979 at the Eurus Theater and ran for 557 performances. The show is Sondheim's most operatic in terms of structure and music. However, it was noteworthy at the time as one of the first 20th century musicals to tackle such dark themes as murder, vengeance, and rape. The show poses complex questions about morality and justice, and delves deep into the twisted psychology of its characters. In its original Broadway run, the show was praised by critics and audiences alike, and was nominated for 9 Tony Awards, winning 8. The song Epiphany represents Sweeney Todd's descent into madness, after he fails to kill the man who killed his wife and imprisoned his daughter.
All this rumbling and shouting. What's happening, dear?
I had him! His throat was bare beneath my hand. No, I had him!
Oh, no,
his
throat dear,
was bare,
no,
now he'll never come again.
Easy now. Hush, love, hush. I keep telling
wait.
You.
Wait! Why did I wait?
Hush.
You told me to wait. Now he'll never come again. There's a hole in the world like a great black pit. It's filled with people who are filled with shit. And the vermin of the world inhabit it. But not for long. They all deserve to die. Tell you why, Mrs. Lovett, tell you why. Because in all of the whole human race, Mrs. Lovett, there are 2 kinds of people, only 2. There's the one staying put in his proper place, and the one with his foot in the other one's face. Look at me, Mrs. Lovett, look at you. No, we all deserve to die. Even you, Mrs. Lovett, even I. Because the lives of the wicked should be made brief for the rest of us. Death will be a relief. We all deserve to die. And I'll never see Joanna. No, I'll never hold my girl again. Finished. You, sir? You, sir? How about a shave? Come and visit your good friend Sweeney. You, sir? Two, sir? Welcome to the grave. I will have vengeance. I will have salvation. Who, sir? You, sir? No one's in the chair. Come on, come on! Sweeney's waiting. I want your bleeders. You, sir? Anybody? Gentlemen, now don't be shy. Not one man. No, nor 10 men. Nor 100 will assuage me. I will have you. And I will get him back even as he gloats. In the meantime, I'll practice on less honorable throat. And my Lucy lies in ashes. And I'll never see my girl again. But the work waits. I'm alive at last, and I'm full of joy.
Company was revolutionary as one of the first concept musicals. Its plot revolves around Robert, a single man unable to commit fully to a steady relationship, the 5 married couples who are his best friends, and his 3 girlfriends. Unlike most book musicals, which follow a clearly delineated plot, Company is a concept musical composed of short vignettes presented in no particular chronological order, linked by a celebration for Robert's 35th birthday. The original production was nominated for a record-setting 14 Tony Awards, and it won 6. The number Being Alive shows Bobby's complex feelings towards forming relationships, and his fears about committing to another person, as well as the pressure of society to marry and settle down.
What do you get? Someone to hold you too close. Someone to hurt you too deep. Someone to sit in your chair to ruin your sleep.
That's true, but there's more than that.
Is that all you think there is to it?
You've got so many reasons for not being with someone, but Robert, you haven't got one reason for being alone.
Come on, you're on to something, Bobby. You're on to something.
Someone to need you too much. someone to know you too well. Someone to pull you up short, to put you through hell.
You're not a kid anymore, Robert. And I don't think you'll ever be a kid again, kiddo.
Hey, buddy. Don't be afraid it won't be perfect. The only thing to be afraid of, really, is that it won't be.
Don't stop now. Keep going.
Someone you have to let in. Someone whose feelings you spare. Someone who, like it or not, will want you to share a little, a lot.
And what does all that mean?
Robert, how do you know so much about it when you've never been there?
It's much better living it than looking at it, Robert.
Someone to crowd you with love. Someone to force you to care. Someone to make you come through, who'll always be there, as frightened as you of being alive. Being alive. Being alive. Being alive.
Blow out the candles, Robert, and make a wish. Want something. Want something.
Somebody hold me too close. Somebody hurt me too deep. Somebody sit in my chair and ruin my sleep and make me aware of being alive. Being alive. Somebody need me too much. Somebody know me too well. Somebody pull me up short and put me through hell and give me support for being alive. Make me alive. Make me alive. Make me confused. Mock me with praise. Let me be used. Vary my taste. But alone is alone, not alive. Somebody crowd me with love. Somebody force me to care. Somebody make me come through. I'll always be there, as frightened as you, to help us survive. Being alive. Being alive. Being alive.
Alan Menken is one of the most praised and well-known composers to ever write for Broadway. He's most commonly known for partnering with Walt Disney Studios and composing scores for their movies and musicals. Some of his most popular works include The Little Mermaid, Newsies, Aladdin, and so many more. Yet, he's also worked on multiple scores outside of it, such as A Christmas Carol, Sister Act, Rocky, and way many more. He has left such an impact on multiple generations. His music is known by almost anyone you'll ever meet. We're here to showcase some of his best and most iconic work. We hope you enjoy the incredible works of Alan Menken.
The Hunchback of Notre Dame, the 1996 Disney classic, was turned to a Broadway musical in 2014 and is one of Mencken's most underrated works. The story is based on the 1831 novel by Victor Hugo, and it follows a hunchback named Quasimodo, who is a deformed bell ringer at the Notre Dame Cathedral. The story focuses on acceptance in society and how appearance doesn't define you as a person. The very well-known song Out There happens as Quasimodo is speaking with his master Frollo. Frollo tells him that he must not go outside and that the world is a cruel and vile place and that he's a monster and the people of Paris won't accept him. Yet Quasimodo has this intense desire to go outside and see the real world and to have these real life experiences, even if it is just for one day. Here's Justin Ancona singing Out There.
Safe beyond these windows and these parapets of stone, gazing at the people down below me. All my life I watch them as I hide up here alone, hungry for the histories they show me. All my life I memorize their faces, knowing them as they will never know me. All my life I wonder how it feels to pass a day not above them, but part of them. And out there, living in the sun, give me one day out there. All I ask is one to hold forever. Out there, where they all live on, oh, where, what I'd give, what I'd dare, just to live one day out there. Out there among the millers and the weavers and their wives, through the roofs and gables I can see them. Every day they go and gout and go about their lives, heedless of the gift it is to be them. If I was in their skin, I'd treasure every instant out there, strolling by the Seine. Taste a morning out there, like ordinary men who freely walk about there. Just one day, and then I swear I'll be content with my share. Won't resent, won't despair, old and bent, I won't care. I'll have spent one day out in the air.
Our next song, When Will My Life Begin? From Disney's beloved movie, Tangled, about Rapunzel discovering life outside of the tower her mother kept her in. Mencken was pushed out of his comfort zone, composing every song in this movie. He wanted Tangled to have a 60s folk rock influence, unlike the other Disney movies he composed. He took inspiration from the song Chelsea Morning by Joni Mitchell for the upbeat melody and feel of the song When Will My Life Begin, specifically. It goes unnoticed that the characters break out into song a lot less compared to traditional Disney princess movies. For this reason, songs are used more to reveal character traits and less to tell the story. When Will My Life Begin, the opening song, is sung while Rapunzel is doing her chores around the house. Every chore that she does reminds her of the longing she has to go outside and experience life outside the tower her mother has locked her in. Now, here is Charlotte Dipple singing When Will My Life Begin?
Seven a.m. laundry, then mop and shine up. Sleep again, and by then it's like 7:15, and so I'll read a book, or maybe two or three. I'll add a few new paintings to my gallery. Play guitar and nuts and cook and basically just wonder when will my life begin. Then after lunch it's puzzles and darts and baking, papier-mâché, a bit of ballet and chess, pottery and ventriloquy, candle making. Dress and I'll reread the books if I have time to spare. I'll paint the wall some more, I'm sure there's room somewhere. And then I'll brush and brush and brush and brush my hair, stuck in the same place I've always been. I'll keep wandering, wandering, wandering and wandering. When will my life begin?
Our final song is the duet Suddenly Seymour from Little Shop of Horrors. This song was written by Mankin for the musical that came out in 1982, but was also included in the film adaptation, which came out in 1986. The musical is like no other. Little Shop of Horrors is simply about a boy, Seymour, who wants a girl, Audrey, but Seymour has a human-eating plant. This plant helps Seymour woo Audrey, but in the end grows too much to kill and eats them both. Suddenly Seymour is probably the most known song from the show. The song takes place after the ex-boyfriend of Audrey dies. In this duet, the two admit their feelings for each other, and Seymour promises to take care of Audrey. They want to leave and start a new life together. Here is Nina Genzone and Jack McDonough singing Suddenly Seymour.
Up your head, wash off the mascara. Here, take my Kleenex, wipe that lipstick away. Show me your face, clean as the morning. I know things were bad, but now they're okay. Suddenly Seymour is standing beside you. You don't need no makeup, don't have to pretend. Suddenly Seymour is here to provide you sweet understanding. Seymour's your friend.
Dad treated me kindly. Daddy left early. Mama was poor. I'd meet a man and I'd follow him blindly. He'd snap his fingers. Me, I'd say sure. Suddenly Seymour is standing beside me. He don't give me
last till forever. Tell me the bad times are clean washed away.
Please understand that it's still strange and frightening. For losers like I've been, it's so hard to say. Suddenly, Cimore, he purified me. Suddenly,
the girl that's inside you, with sweet understanding,
with sweet
understanding,
with sweet understanding.
Seymour's your
man.
Is one amazing composer. He's been nominated over 100 times for various awards, most of them being Best Original Song and Best Original Score. The Hunchback of Notre Dame was most famously nominated for Best Music and Original Musical for the Academy Awards and Best Original Score for the Golden Globes. It won the BMI Film and TV Award. Tangled was nominated for Best Original Song for the Academy Awards and the Golden Globes. It also won Best Song for a Motion Picture for the Grammys. Little Shop of Horrors was nominated for Best Music and Original Song for the Academy Awards and also won Best Music for Academy of Science Fiction, Fantasy, and Horror Films. I truly believe musical theater and Disney as well would not be where it is today if it were not for Alan Menken. Thank you for listening. We hope you enjoyed.